this view from the listening position. It is memories of great movies, because it is really a movie speaker. That's where it really shines. Just a quick presentation of the F1 loudspeaker. It's been a few years since I designed those. It was the first speaker design I did when I got back into speaker designs and audio. The special thing about the F1 speaker is this lively and dynamic and easy to listen to sound. And this loudspeaker is a very good example to show that speakers do actually sound quite different, and it is possible to design a speaker to have a specific sound character. This speaker is meant to be reasonably affordable, so it's not made of the most expensive parts. It has a reasonably small size. It was originally also intended for movie applications for home theater. So it is from the beginning designed to be able to withstand deliver quite high sound pressure levels. It is also designed with a roll-off in the bus region, so it isn't intended to be a full-range speaker on itself, though it will extend down to around 40 Hz in normal positions and placements in normal rooms. The top end is ribbon tweeter, horn-loaded. And then you have the two 8-inch high-performance woofers. And that is what really makes this sound with this dynamic and lively sound with lots of action down in the upper bass and the lower mid-range. The speaker is ported. You see the ports on each side of the drivers. The ports, I recommend plugging them with foam dampers delivered with the speakers. This will make it easier and better to integrate with the subwoofer system. They require, of course, decent subwoofers, a bass system with decent sound quality and output capacity to be able to match the F1 speakers. As you can see, the inside is it's not a simple box. There are different constructions inside the speaker meant to structurally solidify the cabinet, to prevent any resonances in the cabinet, and also to control the sound that emits backwards into the cabinet from the drivers, because the sound inside the cabinet also reflects outward through the cone of the drivers, so it becomes a part of the sound we hear. The crossover is very advanced. It's what I called a very high slope cutoff. The high section is a fourth order cutoff. It will cut off slightly steeper than that due to combination of acoustic, mechanical and electric cutoff. And then the low frequency drivers, they are rolled off. They have a low pass with this very high roll off characteristic. This is an essential part of this creating the sound of the speaker to make it possible to have a speaker that disappears sort of reasonably well into the sound. It isn't like the F25 speakers, but it has a decent three-dimensionality, decent presentation of the sound stage and the instruments. And if the room is good and the placement is good, it can present some sort of depth and 3D in the imaging. But it isn't, that's not where the F1 speakers really shine. Also the horn with the very controlled radiation pattern makes it better and easier to place the speakers in the room, because it reduces the effect of early reflections from sidewalls. The sensitivity is reasonable for this speaker. It's 94 decibels for 2.83 volts, but it's a 4-ohm speaker, so it needs and it can handle massive amounts of power. The drivers used here, it's a very high performance driver. It has a ferrite magnet, and the magnet structure is so large it barely fits into the hole in the cabinet for the drivers. And from the comments I get, the feedback I get from the sound of the speaker, it pretty much matches what my own impressions are of those speakers, and also that is in line with the intention of the speaker when it was designed.